Hi everyone, welcome to first tutorial of Quick Start to Machine Learning with Jason Nano. In this video content, you will have an introduction for Jason Nano hardware and also we will install TensorFlow on it. Jason Nano is really great development board to start machine learning. Hardware features are enough to play with machine learning applications. It has 128 core for GPU, that makes you can run more parallel process. Also CPU is ARM quad core is perfect. There are also two camera input. You can also use a Raspberry Pi camera module. We will use it in the next lectures. I use B02 board. There is also another old version. Between there are a few differences in point of hardware actually. Some components are removed from the old one or replaced in somewhere in the board. In AO2, there is no two input camera as you see here. In the B01 we use, there are two camera module. Board is really looking fine, but there is one thing that I don't understand. On the board, there are two 5-volt power supply. One of them is for USB that I can understand, but the other one is a jack and it's working 5-volt 4 amps. I prefer high voltage, like 9-volt or 24-volt. That makes easy to find an adapter. So before start, be sure that you use for USB power, it should be 5-volt 2 amps and use qualified cable, which can carry 2 amps current. And also do not use HDMI converter, that also creates a problem. Last thing is about the SD card, use recommended one. Otherwise, you will face with the booting issues. I spent too harsh to solve these things. If you want to use a TensorFlow, I recommend you to use 32 GB SD card. Space is not enough. So to download the SD card, to download the image, there is a website. You can follow the instructions here. Just click this Jason Nano development kit. It installed a Jetpack, but this is around 5.9 GB. This is really high for me. It is zipped, by the way. So it is really high because of there are a lot of tools, there are a lot of frameworks is already installed inside this image. TensorRT, CUDA, in Multimedia APIs, and VisionWorks like this. But everything exists except TensorFlow. It is interesting. We will install TensorFlow also in the next few minutes. Don't worry. We can write the image from tools or from the Linux, it doesn't matter. Before we write the image, just format the SD card. And using an etcher, you can burn your image to SD card, simply. You can also follow these instructions. The SD card input is under the system on chip. It is easy to put. Just put your SD card. After that, you will see in the screen configuration menu. Just next and continue. Choose your language and country. Give it some password here. It is, as you see, it is an Ubuntu-based image. It's correct size. The configuration will take some time. Also, the TensorFlow installation also will take more time. I think it's a good idea to take some cup of coffee. After configuration, you will see some information on the screen. Then after this, if you see the NVIDIA logo, everything is all right. Your image is properly installed. It's great. After this, you will see the desktop with a great wallpaper of the NVIDIA. I really like it, green one. So everything is all right. Let's install TensorFlow. Before, be sure you upgrade and update the system. I did it already. Otherwise, you will face some issues It will not good for you. Then open your web browser after installation, after update and upgrade process. There is a web page from the NVIDIA website. We will follow the instructions there. There is a well explained instructions. Also, this one. Also, you can check later. Maybe some comments can be changed in the next if you want to install again. First, we install the system packages, required packages for TensorFlow. This whole process will take around more than 1 hour. So I will cut the video in some part. After system packages, we will install Python 3pip, which is a package manager like an apt for Debian. Yeah, right now we'll install the Python 3pip. And also we upgrade it, by the way. Otherwise, some tools we cannot see, we cannot install. This is also the problem for the new TensorFlow library. It should be suitable for TensorFlow. We generally use pip3 to install related modules like Matplotlib, PyCamera, or other things for the Python. The next one, setup tools and test resources. So now the final step, install the TensorFlow with this command. It will install the latest one, but as I said before, it will take around one hour or at least half an hour. A few minutes later, I will stop the video. I want to show to the very first beginning of the installation. If you see some issue, you can check. If you don't see the issue in the beginning, then probably you will not see anything in the next. And now I will stop the video. See you after a half hour. After installation, you can simply import TensorFlow to test if it is installed very well. So import TensorFlow STF, as you see, then it is installed and I can simply import it successfully. So that is all for the video, guys. In the next video, we will look at the regression for the next tutorial. Let's see you around.